Now, new research has revealed that thousands of children left primary school last year unable to read confidently.
Well, the figures have been released on World Book Day, where one of the aims is to get youngsters to read more.
Well, now a young woman from Northampton is so determined to give kids a better start, she's enlisted the help of Fixers, the campaign that gives young people a voice, to encourage adults to read children a story.
The Tuba Terror is the world's fastest, curviest water slide.
I get stories read to me from my mum or dad. It's fun when my mum does them because she does funny voices.
My name is Amy Collingwood. I am 22 years old and I live in Northampton. My Fixers project is aimed at encouraging more people to read to children.
That's the baby T-Rex.
Yeah.
Look at that.
My passion for getting adults to read to children really started when I was at university and I ran a little book corner.
It was really lovely to kind of see the impact that reading can have, not just on their reading ability, but also the confidence and all of the other things that come with it. From when I was very little, my mum always read to me. So it was surprising for me to find out that lots of children did not have bedtime stories or didn't have any books at all in their house, which to me is very sad.
Research shows that reading early with your children, even when they're young babies, can have an amazing difference on their learning potential in school, and that children are still reaping the benefits of that early reading experience when they're 15. So it's great that Amy is encouraging parents to share books and stories from a very young age.
With Fixers, I'm planning to make a poster which will be shown all around Northampton and will hopefully make more people stop and think to themselves that they should pick up a book more often than just switching on the telly.
I think most people now, it's like telly before bed, whereas I think it's more relaxing and it's a bit more bonding, isn't it, to have a book.
I wouldn't say I've got the best reading voice, so I can understand some parents not wanting to read out loud. We make money baking delicious cupcakes, but it's definitely worthwhile.
I know that when I'm reading to my nephews, they really come alive with the books and the characters.
Fortunately for me, by the time I knock on Gunnar's door...
I like it when Auntie Amy reads because I can understand the book very well. It's easy to understand when someone's reading to you.
One in three parents are not reading to their children. If they could realise what a massive impact it could have on their child's life going into school and growing up, then I think more people would stop and actually think to do it.
There's clear evidence that shows that children that are read to from an early age are more likely to achieve an education and not fall out of education.
Can you see all the birds? Count them.
I hope that my project will inspire more people to start reading with the children that they know.
What's the monkey doing?
He's stealing the fruit.
He's stealing the fruit, isn't he?
Yeah.
It's not something they just have to do because children need it, but it's something they'll actually enjoy doing.
I like stories to read to me. I just close my eyes and go to bed.
Oh, well done you, eh?
What a sweetie.
Well, to see more about the story and Fixers, or to find help on this particular issue, just to visit the website fixers.org.uk.
Well, World Book Day means only one thing to many school children, Fancy Dress Day. And pupils across the region have been dressing up to go in as their favourite book characters.
Well, we've absolutely loved the pictures you've been sending in to us throughout the day. Let's take a look at a few of them.
Here is 7-year-old Abby. She left for school in Kettering this morning as a pirate with a felt-tip 5 o'clock shadow.
Oh, isn't that brilliant? Now, 5-year-old Zach from Milton Keynes, he went in as a dragon from Room on the Broom, as you can see there.
Oh,
well done, Zach.
Oh, so I love that book. If you're a fan of The Hunger Games, you'll know who Megan from Essex is dressed as. It's Katniss Everdeen.
And it is not just the children who've been dressing up. Teachers are getting involved as well. Anna and Amy and Stevenage, they went to school dressed as Slinky Malinky and Minnie Mouse there. Well done, ladies.
They are brilliant. Thank you for those. And there are plenty more, by the way, on our website and Facebook page.
Yeah, they're all brilliant. Yes.